The Pentagon has always been fascinated by the promise of laser weapons. At first, it seemed like a staple of science fiction. But after decades of development, the US military now boasts some of the world's most lethal laser weapons. One of them recently destroyed a floating target in the Middle East during testing, implying that we may see them more frequently in testing and conflict situations in the coming months. Join us in today's video as we don our combat gears and explore the real-life prototypes of the laser weapons available to the US military. History of US laser weapons. American physicist Ted Maiman was the first to demonstrate the concept of lasers back in the 1960s, but the United States military, faced with the intercontinental ballistic missile threats from the Soviet Union, quickly adopted the technology. The Pentagon made huge strides in the development of laser weapons during the SDI Strategic Defense Program, which began in 1984 and lasted till about 1993. The primary aim of the initiative launched by President Ronald Reagan was to secure its place as the world's most dominant force in space, which would also facilitate the development of an anti-missile protection system for the entire North America. Also, as part of this multi-billion-dollar project, the Pentagon committed to developing nuclear-powered lasers, ground-based lasers, as well as chemical lasers and orbital mirrors. As per reports, another goal of the project was to create a system of orbital stations equipped with chemical lasers. At the time, a couple of prototypes had been proposed with laser systems with a range of between 5 to 20 megawatts. Their mission was to strike out missiles and multiple independent re-entry vehicles as soon as they left the atmosphere. Also, officials contemplated the idea of building a partial laser system located in space. According to reports, this system was equipped with a robust laser complex and an orbital mirror system designed to direct and reflect beams to warheads. The laser complex was positioned in a location that helped to resolve quite a number of issues that engineers were experiencing with the energy heat removal and shield system. But on the other hand, it triggered some problems with the beam power as it traveled through the atmosphere. The idea was to install a collection of laser systems on top of the highest mountains across the United States. If the country ever came under attack from the Soviet Union, the laser systems are automatically triggered to send beams into outer space where concentrating mirrors in the geostationary orbit collect and redirect them to other lasers in the low orbit, which would in turn reflect the beams at the warheads. However, these brilliant ideas didn't see the light of day, largely due to the demise of the Soviet Union, which all but ended the Cold War. But as time went on, developers realized they could use the laser technology to solve other tactical problems as well. And since then, a number of laser weapon projects have been launched. Let's take a look at the most prominent ones. Boeing Yal-1. At the moment, the Boeing Yal-1, formerly known as the Airborne Test Bed, is perhaps the most popular laser weapons project in the United States. With an estimated cost of $700 million, the Boeing Yal-1 is an airborne laser weapons system aircraft built on the Boeing 747-400F architecture, and primarily designed to intercept and shoot down tactical ballistic missiles and intercontinental ballistic missiles. It is powered by Pratt & Whitney PW4062 turbofan engine, enabling it to travel at a maximum cruise speed of 480 knots or 900 kilometers per hour. Initially, the project experienced setbacks due to failed testing and exorbitant cost overruns. However, it finally came to life for a test session in January 2010. The Yal-1 showed a glimpse of its prowess to engage simulated missiles, but it failed to destroy them. 1 month later, the aircraft's massive laser cannon was put to the test yet again off the coast of California, where it shot down a liquid-fueled ballistic missile. But in 2011, after spending $5 billion on development and testing, the U.S. military decided to cut its losses on the Boeing Yal-1 and end the program. Northrop Grumman. The Tactical High Energy Laser, THEL, was another major military project that dominated the headlines in the 90s, alternatively known as the Nautilus Chemical Laser Program. This initiative was a combined effort between the United States Defense Department and the Israeli military. In 2008, the system was upgraded and relaunched as Skyguard. The Northrop Grumman Corporation is also responsible for developing the directed energy laser solution for the U.S. military. The company is also building new prototypes of laser laser weapons for the Navy. Some of them were put to the test on the decommissioned Spruance-class destroyer USS Paul F. Foster. Furthermore, Northrop Grumman is also developing several land-based solid-state devices. Fast forward to 2019, news broke out of a new special laser device produced by Northrop Grumman. With a power reading of 150 kilowatts, the system is designed to shoot down unmanned aerial vehicles on small carriers like the USS Portland LPD-27, Lockheed Martin. It took a while, but Lockheed Martin joined the U.S. laser weapon bandwagon in 2012, unveiling a new weapon known as Area Defense Anti-Munitions, ATOM. It's basically a laser weapon system built to hunt down improvised rockets, unmanned aerial systems, and small boat threats from close range. Between 2012 and 2013, the aerospace company tested this munition against small unmanned aerial vehicles and air missiles from about 1 mile away. Further tests were conducted in 2014, but this time against motorboats. 3 years later, Lockheed Martin carried out testing for a new combat laser with a reported power rating of 60 kilowatts. However, the weapon could only muster a power of 58 kilowatts during testing. At the time, Lockheed Martin claimed the new laser system built for the U.S. Army was 50% more energy efficient than the solid-state laser system, DARPA. As part of the NATO alliance scheme in the 80s, a group of government research institutions in the U.S. under the supervision of the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, DARPA, collaborated with the firms of the West German military industry to develop tactical military air and missile defense systems. Fast forward to 2014, DARPA launched the Excalibur program, an initiative to develop a distinct array of phased optical technologies which would enable the development of scalable laser weapons that are 10 times lighter and more portable than the existing high-power chemical laser systems. It featured a total of 28 fiber lasers combined into a system that's capable of reflecting the beam from a distance of over 4 miles. Each element delivers an emitting power of 10 watts, which are assembled into blocks of 7 pieces measuring almost 4 inches in diameter. However, their power output can be increased by adding extra blocks. According to DARPA, the laser weapons technology invented as part of this program will allow the installation of high-power lasers on a range of military platforms like aircraft without reducing their performance level and efficiency. This was also expected to facilitate the development of 100 kilowatts class laser systems to attack both air and land-based targets. In 2015, DARPA officials confirmed the development of a 150 kilowatt high-power laser system to combat the threats that surface-to-air missiles pose to manned and unmanned military aircraft. These systems were developed under the HELADS program. They operated with an unprecedented speed and power of light to curb these threats. They also provided extra capability and precision for offensive missions. In addition, the high-power laser system were 10 times more compact and lighter than the existing lasers, meaning they can easily be integrated onto aircraft to attack and defend against threats. However, history was made in November 2021 when the U.S. Army awarded a joint contract to Boeing and General Atomics to develop a groundbreaking 300-kilowatt laser weapon. The program, tagged the Distributed Gain High Energy Laser Weapon System, will feature General Motors' Electromagnetic System Distributed Gain Laser and Boeing's Beam Director, as well as precision acquisition, tracking, and pointing software. The high-power compact laser weapon subsystem prototype that GAEMS will deliver under this contract will produce a lethal output greater than anything fielded to date, Scott Forney, president of GAEMS, said in the statement. This technology represents a leap-ahead capability for air and missile defense that is necessary to support the Army's modernization efforts and defeat next-generation threats in a multi-domain battle space, he added. This is a huge milestone in the history of laser weapons technology, and once this weapon is delivered, it will give the United States more firepower to tackle the ever-increasing threats from Russia and other adversaries. What do you make of the United States' advancements in laser technology? Should it be encouraged? Let us know what your thoughts are in the comment section below. Be sure to check out this next video over here.